Hello, and welcome to our program today. We're very happy that you joined us. Summer in our part of the world is giving into autumn. The leaves are starting to change in some places. The morning air is fresher as the mist clears with the warmth of the sun. I don't know about you, but this time of transition is when I notice my natural environment the most. Change is in the air. And with change in natural seasons comes also a change in the focus of our church year. In September, we enter into the season of creation, a time where we reflect on God's great gift of creation and our call to be stewards of that gift. Over the next 3 weeks, we'll be reflecting on three aspects of creation: forests, the wilderness, and rivers. This week, we'll be looking at the gift of the forest. My thanks to Katharine, Sue, Russell, Diane, and Carolyn for their gifts and the blessings that they bring us today.
Let us pray. All-loving God, we pause in our day, asking that you envelop us in the questioning and in the answering. And when we pause, may we see you in nature around us, in our hearts within us, and in the people with whom we cross paths. There are times when we fall to our knees, and times when we rise to the top of a mountain, but we know that we are not alone and we will meet again soon. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Our Father, our Mother, who art in heaven, who art in all the earth, hallowed be thy name. Holy is your truth. Thy kingdom come. May your wisdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Your circle be one, uniting heaven and earth. Give us this day our daily bread. Give us today a nurturing spirit. And forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Heal through us as we ourselves are healed. Lead us not into temptation. Lead us into fullness of life. Deliver us from evil and liberate all that is good. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory. For the wisdom, presence, and goodness are yours, now and forever. Amen.
First reading today is from Psalm 104, verses 1 to 9, 16 to 22, and 27 to 31. This is a psalm of praise for creation, and I'm reading from the Message Bible. Listen. O my soul, bless God. God, my great, how great you are, beautifully, gloriously robed, dressed up in sunshine, and all heaven stretched out for your tent. You built your palace on the ocean deeps, made a chariot out of clouds, and took off on wind wings. You commandeered winds as messengers, appointed fire and flame as ambassadors. You set earth on a firm foundation so that nothing can shake it, ever. You blanketed earth with ocean, covered the mountains with deep waters. Then you roared, and the water ran away. Your thunder crash put it to flight. Mountains pushed up, valleys spread out in the places you assigned them. You set boundaries between earth and sea. Never again will earth be flooded. God's trees are well watered, the Lebanon cedars he planted. Birds built their nests in those trees. Look, the stork at home in the treetop. Mountain goats climb about the cliffs. Badgers burrow among the rocks. The moon keeps track of the seasons. The sun is in charge of each day. When it's dark and night takes over, all the forest creatures come out. The young lions roar for their prey, clamoring to God for their supper. When the sun comes up, they vanish, lazily stretched out in their dens. All the creatures look expectantly to you to give them their meals on time. You come and they gather around. You open your hand and they eat from it. If you turn your back, they die in a minute. Take back your spirit and they die. Revert to original mud. Send out your spirit and they spring to life, the whole countryside in bloom and blossom. The glory of God, let it last forever. Let God enjoy his creation. And now the second reading is from Ezekiel chapter 31, verses 3 to 9. It describes the power of the forest. Look, Assyria was a big tree, huge as a Lebanon cedar, beautiful limbs offering cool shade, skyscraper high, piercing the clouds. The waters gave it drink, the primordial deep lifted it high, gushing out rivers around the place where it was planted, and then branching out in streams to all the trees in the forest. It was immense, dwarfing all the trees in the forest. Thick boughs, long limbs, roots delving deep into earth's waters. All the birds of the air nested in its boughs. All the wild animals gave birth under its branches. All the mighty nations lived in its shade. It was stunning in its majesty, the reach of its branches, the depth of its water-seeking roots. Not a cedar in God's garden came close to it. No pine tree was anything like it. Mighty oaks looked like bushes growing alongside it. Not a tree in God's garden was in the same class of beauty. I made it beautiful, a work of art in limbs and leaves, the envy of every tree in Eden, every last tree in God's garden. Bless these words to our use and understanding.
Thank you, Sue. Now, would you say it is easier to care or help for a stranger or a friend? I ask this question as a point of departure into the value of forests in our lives. Forests feature prominently in our daily life, though we're not always aware of it. They convert carbon dioxide into various carbon compounds that make up the leaves, the bark, and the wood of our trees and of our natural environment. They house a multitude of creatures, many still undiscovered. They represent a balance between life and death, decomposition and new life. They provide us with shelter and oxygen. We depend on them and they depend on us. Forests are creatures in and of themselves. They are a complexity of organisms communicating with each other, acting as one. Over the recent years, we've learned about how even trees communicate with one another, how one end of the forest communicates with the other end of the forest. If we want to see how the web of life works, there's no better place to look than the forest. And we are called by God, the Creator, to care for creation, especially our forests. Unfortunately, we are more and more an urbanized people. Some are very lucky to have things like cottages, but the vast majority of us have difficulty remembering the last time we were in a forest. Our distance from the forest has meant that we are not as aware of it, and it's harder to care for something or someone with whom we have little or no familiarity. Our estrangement from the forest has come at a great cost, not only to the forest, but to ourselves. You see, the forest has more to give us than just lumber for our houses and a unique plant or fungus containing some miracle cure. If you can, try and recall the last time you were in a forest. How did it make you feel? For most people, being in that forest environment brought them a sense of peace, a relaxation, a sense of calm. This has prompted some people to look into the value of the forest in terms of our own physical, mental, and spiritual being. And so from 2004 to 2012, Japanese officials spent about $4 million studying the physiological and psychological effect of what they called Shinrin-Koyu, or forest bathing. One scientist measured the activity of the what's called the human natural killer cells that are associated with our immune system. He looked at them before and after exposure to being in the forest, and he discovered that there was a significant increase in these cells in the week after the visit to the forest, and those positive effects continued for a month following each weekend spent in the forest. The Japanese government was so impressed with results of these studies that in one forest, doctors are at hand to give you a health check and do a psychological assessment, which they then use to create the best walking plan for you. Forest bathing, as they called it, is proven to lower heart rate and blood pressure. It reduces stress hormone production. It boosts the immune system and it improves overall feelings of well-being. Studies in other parts of the world have found the benefits of the forest and nature in general are worthy of our attention. In Finland, a government-funded researcher recommends a minimum nature dose of 5 hours a month in order to reduce the level of depression, alcoholism, and suicide. In South Korea, there is now a free program of nature therapy sponsored by the government for post-traumatic stress syndrome in firefighters. The University of Essex in the UK found that a walk in the country reduces depression in 71% of participants. Clinical psychologist Scott B. points out that the sights, sounds, and smells of the forest take us right into that moment so that our brains stop anticipating, recalling, ruminating, and worrying. Forest therapy results in decreased anxiety, and we've seen increased strengthened immune systems. People in the forest inhale beneficial bacteria and plant-based essential oils, as well as negatively charged ions. Forest therapy reduces cortisol and actually can have a positive impact on blood pressure and a protein that helps regulate blood sugar levels. And as Scott B. pointed out, that the ease of which the forest takes us out of ourselves and puts us in a different space means that it's a great way to get started with this idea of mindfulness training. Well, one person, Melanie Hazel, ran her own leadership and career coaching company. She gave all that up to become one of Ontario's first 20 forest therapy guides. She comments that since she was a child, she always felt more alive in nature. Intuitively, we know that there is a link between well-being and nature. But when she found the science behind it, it made that connection even more powerful for her. As she says, it reminds me that the world is a lot bigger than me, and it gives me a new perspective. It also improves my mood, memory, and cognition. And through her work as a forest therapy guide, she noticed that she has seen forest therapy walks combat depression, anxiety, conditions like ADHD, as well as improving one's own empathy. When we reflect on that idea that she brings up where it improves mood, memory, and cognition, people have found also that it helps them with creativity, with seeing things in a new way. So what is forest therapy anyway? How do we get into it? It sounds like it could be very helpful. Well, it's more than just a walk in the forest. It's more than just reaching a destination. It means spending time in the forest, slowing down in the forest. And when we slow down, we discover the beautiful things that we wouldn't normally discover. It means using all our senses to experience the forest, to breathe in the air, to breathe in those bacteria, those natural oils. Taking time to smell what's going on, to feel what's happening in the forest. Taking time to notice the little things around us. Most forest therapy people recommend at least 2 hours, spending 2 hours in the forest, not thinking about where you're going, but being where you are, taking a slow meander walk through the forest, stopping and spending 15 minutes in a place, getting to know the textures of things and the smells of things. You see, what forest therapy does is that helps us understand the forest. And as I said, it's easier to care for something that you understand, that you know, than someone you don't. And so forest therapy not only then helps us, but it helps the forest itself. It's strengthening the relationship between the non-human world in order to be fully whole as we can be. It's a way of improving our relationship with nature. As one author wrote, she believes that when we form relationships, we care more about the thing or that person. On the other hand, as I said, when we don't have a relationship with something, we aren't looking out for it. Our relationship with the forest is crucial to our own survival. We have to fight to keep that relationship intact. If we don't acknowledge the extent to which nature supports us, then we don't understand ourselves. We don't understand the web of life. And forest therapy helps us remember our place in the web of life, in our relationship with all nature and beings. So you see, the forest has a wonderful gift to give us. And its gift is not just for the moment, but it's something that most people have discovered they can come back to no matter where they are. Just like I asked you to remember the last time you were in a forest. Didn't some of those feelings come back to you as you used your imagination? Well, going into the forest even for 20 minutes, 30 minutes, and spending some slow time there rejuvenates us, gives us that peace. And the more we can do that, the more we can bring back into our world, into our urban world. Take some time this week. If you have a forest nearby, go visit it. Take some time in nature and think about what's happening around you. Looking at the little things, breathing the air, taking a moment, no matter where you're doing outside, and giving thanks for the gift that nature, and especially the forest, brings you. Amen.
Mm-hmm. earliest days of childhood, playing in the deep woods, stomping through the creek and feeling oh so much alive. We're camping in the forest, we join the cricket chorus and hum our songs of gratitude around the crackling fire. And out here in the stillness, I found my house of worship with column trees and canopy of stars. Here my cathedral, it was beneath the blue skies, ran down to be baptized. I felt the river wash me clean and dried beneath the sun. And to this day, believing, wide awake or dreaming, I scan the ancient sky and understand where I belong. Out here in the stillness, I find my house of worship with column trees and canopy of stars. Here in my cathedral, this is where I find my soul. Out where holy man of old first knelt in soil and thanked you for the rain, wrote the songs that filled the air, herald angels sang their prayer, out beneath your darling constellations. So let me off and wander in robin song and thunder, surrounding me with stained glass leaves that change with every breeze. And out here in the stillness, I find my house of worship with column trees and canopy of stars. Here in my cathedral.
Let us pray. Loving Creator, we give you thanks for the gift of nature that surrounds us, the great web of life of which we are a part. Help us to take the time to experience that web, to experience the beauty of the forest and of nature, and the gift that it provides us, and the gift that we can be to it. Help us to love it as you love it, and be stewards of it. We continue to pray for all those in caring professions during this time of pandemic. We pray for people in care facilities and senior homes. We pray for students and teachers and administrators as we walk through this time of going back to school. And we pray that you would watch over us and help us to find ways and encourage us to keep each other safe. We pray for all those we know who are looking to you for special needs and concerns. For Jerry, Sandra, Renee, Paul, Betty, Gwen, Anne, and Jerry, Rena and Ray, Marion, Francis, Eleanor, Elgus, and Peggy, as well as those whom we name before you in our hearts. May they be aware of the love that flows through them and those who walk with them. Grant wisdom and understanding to all their caregivers. And we give thanks for the blessing of everyone watching this program today. May the light of creation shine upon each one of us, and may love enfold us. May we continue to grow in the awareness of the depth of love that surrounds and supports us, and the whole of creation. May the pure light within each one of us guide us. May we be blessed, encouraged, and empowered in every aspect of our lives. We ask this through the living Christ, our companion on the way, as we pray in the spirit of St. Francis. As I live every day, I want to be a channel for peace. May I bring love where there is hatred, and healing where there is hurt, joy where there is sadness, and hope where there is fear. I pray that I may always try to understand and comfort other people, as well as seeking comfort and understanding from them. Wherever possible, may I choose to be a light in the darkness, a help in times of need,
and a caring, honest friend. And may justice, kindness, and peace flow from my heart forever. Amen.
Thank you again for joining us. Remember to continue to subscribe and like our program. We also enjoy reading your comments, whether they are on our YouTube site or our Facebook page. We realize that these are continuing to be difficult times, but if you can, please consider making a donation to St. John's. The information on how to do that is posted below in the description box. We are thankful for all your support. Well, the beauty of nature, as I said, is changing around us, and I invite you to go out and experience nature, especially get out into the forest, and take some time to be there. I'll be posting a link in the box, in our description box, to some other ideas of how we can experience the forest and take that nature bath there. And we go knowing that nature shows us that love of God that surrounds us and goes through us, that the Spirit does dwell within each one of us to empower and inspire us, and we have Jesus as a guide and friend. Amen.